Hello, it's Jang here with a look at a classic Legoland town set from 1988. This is called the Vacation Camper. Comes with these two minifigures, a car or SUV type thing, depending upon how you want to look at the scale of this, and then a trailer or caravan. As of 1988, this general size and style of car had been around for pretty much a decade. There are some differences here with the use of the vertical windscreen piece in the back, completely flat, straight up and down. It's also got the little moonroof, sunroof set up there. This is set up as kind of an aerodynamic cowling. Kind of looks like a spoiler, but I think it's intended to be cowling to help the aerodynamics with the camper on the back. It also has a little bit of a different style with the grille down so close to the ground here, along with those headlights. It's got the opening doors, of course, and you could swing open the entire roof to get actual access. Wow, these are old pieces. They're kind of sticking together. I did do the nice treatment on them to get them refreshened up, but you can swing that back, let you get easier access into the driver's compartment to put your figure in there. You notice this does have the ball hitch on the back. And let's go ahead and pull this off, separate this, and then take a look at just this section. So the camper used the little stretcher style wheels in the front that you could bring down, so that acts as a stand for it. This is a printed piece right here, which I think would tend to represent the ducts for a little AC, little portable AC unit or something like that. Definitely adds some texture there. Lots of nice clear windows all around this. This is very interesting here on the top with the use of a tile piece, a 2x2 tile and transparent clear. You don't see those anymore, do you? That's intended to represent the positioning of a skylight up there, I believe, that would actually be letting light in. Of course, it's not transparent all the way through because this is opaque white here, but I think it's the thought that counts a little bit more than anything here. And you can definitely get into the feeling of this. Very open. It almost looks like this is a food dispensary, you know, a mobile little food truck kind of trailer sort of thing. This all opens up. And then you can get inside. You can see you've got a 2x2 brick that represents a table in the middle, a couple of things to drink out of there. I guess you're supposed to be able to rest up there, but it's pretty much just open empty space. And then back over here you've got a sink to represent the rest of a little bit of a kitchen area. So really not a lot going on inside of this thing at all, but I still like it. I especially like the pieces here. I think this is a little bit newer of a piece just from looking at the color of it. This one's a little bit older here. But just all the clear stuff, and for its day, I feel like this felt very fresh and lively. And gosh, it would be great to be able to have more of those pieces nowadays. Around the back, you can see that the windscreen piece gives you full visibility from around the back, and then on the other side, things are pretty much mirrored. You can just see the hinges. That's pretty much all that's different, and it doesn't open up on this side. Two minifigures came with this set, one male, one female. They're kind of color coordinated to the vehicle and the trailer, and just kind of fit in with that. You can see that the print on this guy's torso is off just a little bit, and the print on the female character's face is just a little bit more worn, probably from a little bit different age. I did not get this new, obviously, so over time pieces tend to get swapped out. You get one little piece of luggage there, no print on the back of here. Of course, during these days, no prints on the backs of the heads or anything. It's the second female specific hair, I believe, that they came out with. So that's the Vacation Camper of 1988. More recent renditions of this basic theme of set have kind of brought things down to one single piece, one single assembly with a larger RV. Of course, scale is completely different nowadays. I feel like for the day of this set, for its age, this is pretty nicely done. I especially like all the windows around on the trailer. But I wish it had just a couple more details on the inside of there just to make it a little bit more lively and have you do something other than just drinking from the faucet that's in the back. If you have any additional thoughts about this set, please do share down in the comments section. Thanks for taking the time to watch the video, and stick around for more, because more are on the way. Bye for now.